This cloning is a process of copying the contents of one computer's hard drive to another or to an image file. Unlike standard copying procedures, this cloning involves copying hidden and in-use files and thus preventing special changes, as those types of files are typically not available for copying. I ripped that straight from Wikipedia because I'm too lazy to make my own formal definition. Simply put, we copy over bit by bit the contents of drive A over to drive B. This includes hidden partitions like the boot sector, recovery partitions, and Windows EFI partitions. This process do require the use of third-party software, and the one we are going to be using in this video is Macrium Reflect Free. I picked this software for cloning because it has a clean and simple UI. For this entire video, I would call the original hard disk drive, drive A, while the destination SSD, drive B. A simple scenario is that all you have is the EFI partition, Windows C partition, maybe a separate data partition, and maybe the recovery partition if you still have it. Assuming you are going dual drive, clone only Windows EFI and the Windows partition. Leave data and the large recovery partition on the hard disk drive to save space on the smaller SSD. Windows tends to create extra little partitions before and after the Windows partitions, especially after a major update. When cloning, you have to include those, and those are small anyway at like under a gigabyte. Now, I can't guarantee that the recovery partition would still work when placed on a different drive. In this case, it stays on the hard disk drive. But I don't care. A clean install of Windows is still best to avoid any pre-installed crap by your computer manufacturer. If you have all your personal data, like pictures, music, movies, memes, on the same partition as Windows, and the total use space is more than what your SSD can hold, you should move your personal data over to an external drive until you can fit Windows on it. If it is still too tight, you'll need to uninstall your large programs like games and reinstall it later on the hard disk drive, but at this point it is more beneficial for you to just have a bigger SSD. So first, we download the free home version of the software, then downloaded it again because that was just the downloader. Home license, this part is optional, I want a clean desktop, then finish. Now that we know what to include, let's fire up Macrium. So uncheck all the drives but the one that is going to be cloned. Pick your SSD, then check the partitions you want to copy. Select clone to disk, next, next, finish, then OK. When you have those extra little partitions before and after Windows, it may err out saying not all copied, insufficient space. In this scenario, we sacrifice some space on the Windows partition, then drag the last little partition over to that space. A little adjustment on that little partition and you're good to go. There should be no errors during the entire process. Once successful, you will see that you now have another smaller Windows partition in this PC. To avoid any confusion, I recommend naming it Windows SSD. Go and restart your computer. The hotkey to bring up the boot menu during startup varies from laptop to laptop. In some cases, jabbing that key isn't enough. Sometimes you have to hold down the key as soon as the power LED on your computer turns on. Another method is to using another hotkey. Go to setup and change the boot order so that the SSD is picked first. We need to do this so, one, we boot into the SSD instead of the hard disk drive, and two, to verify that the cloning process is successful. If it goes as planned, you should see that Windows SSD is now C drive, and you should notice that you booted up much faster than before. Maybe even do a comparison where you stopwatch the boot up time between the hard disk drive and the SSD from a cold start, like a restart. Once booted up, go to disk management and delete the Windows partitions and other extra partitions from the hard disk drive. Look carefully and delete it from the hard disk drive, not the SSD. Also, if you still have the data partition and the recovery partition on the old drive, leave it there. This process will either leave you a completely blank hard disk drive or only be left with the recovery partition, or the first half of it unallocated if you still have the data partition. This is easy. Format the unallocated space as your data partition. Pick a drive letter like D, because some of you want the D, to keep things simple so that Windows is on C and data on D. For file system, pick NTFS or XFAT if you're going to want Linux to access it in the future for some reason. Default allocation, quick format, and you're done. If you moved your personal data out to an external drive, you can now move it into here. You can extend the data partition to the unallocated space before it and have a dynamic disk, but Microsoft no longer recommends that. You can instead format that unallocated space as another data partition, but once things start to fill up, you have a lot of moving files back and forth to do. The best solution is to just move your personal data to an external drive, delete that data partition, then follow the steps in scenario one. We're done. With this setup, you now have Windows and your programs on the nice and snappy SSD, while your larger personal data like pictures, movies, and whatever on the hard disk drive. Likers gonna like, haters gonna hate, subscribe so you don't miss any of my future videos, and thank you for watching. Also, feel free to watch this guide if you become unsure at a certain step. Best to double check now, then screw up later.